Let's start first with this. The police chief of Calbayog City Summer sacked. It's another police operation that's quite controversial. That's just one in a few we've seen in recent weeks.
Well, a few is an understatement. This has been happening regularly, almost daily, killings left and right, whether it's involving policemen in a shootout or lawyers who are lawyering for suspected communists or farmers, groups, human rights organizations, a mother who is jailed because of being involved supposedly in illegal activities. The rule of law is under siege, obviously, and this is a challenge. And we welcome actually some of the statements being raised by lawyers groups, the IBP, the Philippine Bar Association, Free Legal Assistance Group, no less than the Secretary of Justice, Attorney Secretary Guevara, has expressed alarm over the spate of killings. They are saying that 54 lawyers have been killed since 2016, since the start of this administration. And if you go back as far back as the Marcos regime, they're saying 80 lawyers have been killed in connection with or in connection with cases that they're handling. So 61 of the 80 has happened in the last 4 years. So that gives you a sense of precisely the rule of law under siege. And the police, who have repeatedly been involved in abuses and questionable shootouts, patuloy pa rin ang nakikita natin. The wanton disregard for the law, the impunity, and the defense of the administration towards these abuses and these excesses in violence, what we call, you know, the only violence that's legitimate under our, you know, constitutional democracy is the legitimate use of force of the police and the armed forces.
Okay.
Obviously, now, there's been a lot of excesses and abuses.
Senator Pangilinan, the PNP, to their defense, might end up saying these are isolated cases. Like, for example, let me quote this one.
54 lawyers killed in the last 4 years. No way in any stretch of imagination can you say that's isolated. I beg to disagree with the observations if this will be one of the issues raised by the PNP, that these are isolated cases. They are not isolated cases.
Mm-mm. Okay, Senator, they describe General Eleazar, of course, relieved Montaño for command responsibility, but he also blames the irresponsible conduct of the police intelligence officer. In other words, they are citing specific people in specific instances instead of the culture of impunity.
And if I may add, and they're doing this, and we're thankful they're doing this, but they're doing this precisely because there has been a public outcry, lalo na sa legal profession. The Philippine Bar Association, one of the oldest associations of lawyers, it's a very conservative organization, but having seeing them coming up with a public statement of concern is really an indicator of how the legal circles are not taking this sitting down. So vigilance is key, public outcry and organized efforts to oppose these incidents are also key. And yes, we welcome the relief, but we hope to see accountability. We also welcome, for example, the acts of the armed forces of the Philippines and the DND when they came up with this red tagging, erroneous, ridiculous list of former UP students who supposedly got captured and killed. They sacked and removed the deputy chief of staff for intelligence. So this is how we should respond to impunity. This is how we should respond to incompetence or anomalous or questionable acts on the part of our armed forces and the part of our PNP.